Because lots of travellers cross the Pacific by ship and plane to New Zealand and step ashore here at Auckland, we sometimes say that this is the gateway to New Zealand. In a few days here, or even a few hours, you can take a quick look at us, where and how we live. Auckland's our largest city, but it's not the capital, that's Wellington. It's not even a large city by some standards. Only about 250,000 of us live in it, but we live in much the same way as people do in cities everywhere. You won't see skyscrapers or subways. Experts tell us the climate's semi-tropical, which means it can rain suddenly. But it clears up. Our forefathers, who started to build this city about 1840, chose a good place. On the shores of a harbour, some people say, is one of the finest in the world. Most of those people live in Auckland. Being British, we naturally like it for trade and for sport. Yachting or pottering about in small boats is popular in many parts of the country. But this good harbour here has become the main centre for the sport. Most people can't afford big yachts, so they've gone in for smaller craft, types they can build themselves and types that suit the conditions. Yachting is one of the joys of Auckland, and it's a joy to watch. We like the open wherever we can. Fishes around the coast here give us plenty of chances to swim and catch all the sun we want. There's lots of beaches and not many of us, so the beaches aren't overcrowded. We're a home-loving people too, but like other countries today, we're short of homes. By government effort and private enterprise, however, we're making up leeway. In the past, we built good, solid homes, though we probably could have done better in design. You'll see blocks of flats rising up here and there in face of the housing shortage. But we haven't concentrated on homes and offices, shops and factories altogether. This Auckland War Memorial was built in memory of those relatives of ours who died in World War I. Moving out of Auckland, you'll see that more and more factories are springing up on the outskirts. Our population's growing rapidly, and more people are being employed in making things. This means our roads are carrying more traffic. The school patrol is our answer to one danger to our children. Going to school and coming away, they control the traffic themselves on the roads near the school. Now we're getting out into farmlands, where our real wealth comes from, where people grow things. Around here, just south of Auckland, are some of our richest dairy lands. We run a lot of sheep in other parts, but dairying's our main industry. Butter and cheese are among our best exports, best for quality and best for profits. We call this area the Waikato, after the name of the river that waters it, the Waikato River. It helps to keep those good dairy land pastures good. That and science and hard work. While it provides us with some pretty scenery, it also supplies electricity. We're building a series of dams and powerhouses down it, part of one of our biggest hydroelectric schemes. We started getting electricity from our rivers and lakes, with a lot of them, way back in 1887. And we've gone on doing it because we have no oil of our own and our coal supplies are only moderate. But we need more and more power for our farms, for the milking machines, dairy factories, homes, towns, industry, cities, big towns and small towns. This is Cambridge, a typical small town south of Auckland. Around here, you find another industry that's important to us too, the breeding of thoroughbreds. This is just one of several good stud farms, 750 acres of rich Waikato pasture land where thoroughbreds mature naturally, out in the open all the year round. The horses we breed are known throughout the racing world, and you can find in our stud farms strains of all the great thoroughbred families. Some people say racing's a disease with us, but perhaps we just love horses. In all this country, there's a lot of variety. Way across there is Lake Rotorua, so we're coming to one of the best known parts of the Dominion now. Here's the town of Rotorua. A small town, but a big attraction for travellers. It's the centre of a great thermal region, often called a thermal wonderland. Thousands of travellers come here from all over the globe, which is all good for the hotel business. But they get their money's worth. Sportsmen too come here for the trout fishing. Health seekers come because of the baths, mineral baths and modern treatments of many different kinds. A lot of people have found it's a good place to get well in. Most people come here to see the sights of this thermal region, where the Earth's crust is split and broken and you can see nature's underworld at work. Geysers that burst high into the air, steaming earth, pools of water that are boiling hot alongside streams that are icy cold. It's a region of weird beauty. They call these pools of boiling mud porridge pots. Here too, you can meet some of our Maori people, still living close to their native way of life, as close as the 20th century will let them. Those who live in these parts can cook their dinner in a pressure cooker nature gave them hundreds of years ago. And you'll find some of them still weaving their baskets and their mats from flax, as they have always done. These people share New Zealand with us, on an equal footing and with equal rights. Elsewhere, they live and work as we do, in a country we know is small, but holds a lot of interest for the traveller.